is mine. Get back. Don't fuck with my stack. The gauge is whack. About to drop the bomb. I'm the motherfucking dime. Big fish in a small pond.
Well, but I've been shut out. You know, some platforms will not have me on.
Why?
They don't like that I'm, you know, an independent thinker. I'm not part of the herd. I'm not part of the go along to get along gang. I've been excluded. I've been excluded on Oprah, you know.
On Oprah? What?
On Oprah, yeah, I've been excluded. Yeah, man.
I would think you'd be the person Oprah would want to promote. I mean, you grew up in South Central. You were successful at a young age. You have dignity. You say what you think. Like, I thought that was the goal.
Me too. You know, whether they become independents and not vote for anybody who's not bringing it. You know, it's like people want your vote. They have to do something to earn it. If they don't earn it, why are you going down there and pulling that lever?
Good day, good people. It's your mail carrier, QT Dub, with another edition of
The Independent Mail.
Yo.
Subscribe, subscribe, subscribe.
Also, if you're feeling this video, hit that like and share. I'm still a super small channel and YouTube has a hard time placing my videos. Friday, I did a video talking about Lizzo and it was suggested after my husband rates my baby shower, a Barbie the movie video, and a video about a lady releasing her R&B single. None of those audiences wanted to see me talking about Lizzo. Anyway, I finally got a chance to see the interview with Ice Cube and Tucker freaking Carlson this weekend. You know Tucker came to the sit down ready to engage with his usual confused yet interested gaze that made him famous on Fox News. No, seriously, it was a super engaging, really good interview. In fact, I actually want to share some of it with you guys and do a little reaction to some of it. So let's check it out.
Should be doing this of all interviews? I mean, you could do an interview with anyone. You're doing an interview with me. Obviously, you're going to take abuse for doing that. Like, why would you do that?
Because I think it's silly not to talk to people.
Exactly. I don't know why a segment of people have been wanting to put a Kanye red hat on Cube. All because he's been willing to have sit downs to get things done. Cube's not doing this.
You hear about slavery for 400 years. For 400 years? That sounds like a choice.
So I remember reading you say something along the lines of, I didn't vote for Trump, I'm not a Trump voter. You actually attacked Trump at one point, but you were willing to meet with Trump. Do you think that crossed the line?
I think some people didn't like that, but I think it's idiotic. You know, enemies meet.
Right.
You know, they talk. I'm pretty sure there's some communication between Russia and the Ukraine right now. Somebody's on the phone talking to somebody.
Again, exactly. That was a great example or a great analogy. Even nations at war communicate. You can't go put a red hat on a man just because he's willing to have a sit down to get things done. Now, to be fair, there were those that didn't like the idea of him having to sit down with the Trump administration because up until that point, all meetings with minority groups had just been photo ops. Let's take the meeting with the HSBC group. All you got was a photo opportunity, a disinterested Kellyanne Conway playing on the phone with her feet on the furniture, and then the segment of the party went on to attack critical race theory, and other states even went along to ban certain aspects of Black history curriculum. So,
we will get critical race theory out of our schools.
Ron DeSantis defending his decision to block a new advanced placement course on African American studies from being taught in Florida schools. He says Florida's current standards for teaching Black history are, quote, cut and dried history, and that multiple lessons in that particular course go too far. Here he is.
We want education, not indoctrination.
You do have that, so I do understand that piece of concern about not having him have to sit down, but understand where he's coming from. Don't throw the red hat on him.
What do you think of Biden?
I don't think he's giving the people who put him in exactly what they thought they were going to get from him. People want your vote. They have to do something to earn it. If they don't earn it, why are you going down there and pulling that lever?
The other side hates you. That's the pitch they make. We may suck, but the other side hates you.
Here we go. Classic Tucker. Come on, bro. Why are the Democrats able to say, because they hate you? Why?
Friday night, hundreds of white nationalists storming the University of Virginia, protesting plans to remove a statue of Confederate General Robert E. Lee.
Very fine people on both sides.
What's your view of the police at this point?
It's the same. You know, they really is, you know. It's yeah. So it's a fraternity. It's an organization that does things a certain way. And I think their philosophy sometimes is detrimental to the people they're serving, because I think cops have a win and make it home philosophy. Win whatever battles you have in the street, make it home at night. And that's actually the most important thing. And everything else, people's rights, doing things the right way, you know, being totally fair and square all the time and not, you know, being a little aggressive, you know, all that comes second to win the encounter, make it home at night.
Man, Cube was spot on with his description of the police. You add a hyper sense of respect my authority to that win in the streets and make it home mentality, and you've got a pretty dangerous mix. That mentality and fraternity style mindset is exactly what the Democrats horribly communicated with their defund the police campaign. Reform is definitely due, though. That win and make it home mentality is subpar for those that we entrust to arrest and to make lethal decisions. We should expect more. This isn't Home Depot we're talking about.
Do you think that it's harder to be a man in America now than it was when you were a kid?
Yes. Saying what you feel, being yourself, is what they call toxic.
So there are some groups, like if I say I'm trans, then people say, that's great, you were born that way, we affirm you. But if you say I'm just a dude with male instincts, you're not affirmed, you're attacked.
Yeah, I mean, everybody doesn't really have to affirm you, you know? If I wake up and say, you know, I feel like a pigeon, I want everybody to treat me like a pigeon. Some people may say, whatever, Q, we treat you like a pigeon. But some people may choose to be like, dude, no. That's your world. Yeah. I'm not part of it. And I have to be ready for that. It's a big world out here. Everybody doesn't have to adhere to me.
Man, there's nothing to add to that. Everyone doesn't have to adhere to me. Everyone doesn't have to adhere to my reality, to my truth, to my universe. Well said. Well said. Yo, this was a great interview in my opinion. I really suggest you guys check it out. Check out the whole interview. It's probably like 30 minutes. Put it on while you're working or ironing or whatever, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna put the link in the description. But I feel like I have a better perspective of Cube and his politics and where he's coming from. I mean, shoot, he appears to be an independent male, you know what I'm saying? But seriously, let me know what you guys think. Did you enjoy the segments of the interview? Do you feel like you know Cube a little bit better? Did you feel like you gained better perspective? Did you like his assessments about politics, about the police, and about everybody not having to adhere to, you know, our truths? But until next time, guys, peace and stay informed.